Yeah, one of the things that I kind of think about every now and then when I hear about people like, say, Cantwell, sort of a type who says, we need to kill all the Jews or something like that. And, you know, they're using that word we. That's like the whole, you know, the big sort of part of it, in my opinion, because I want to say to them, and I have said this to people on Facebook a few times when I see people saying things like that, like, we need to do this, like, we need to go and make, you know, and I'm like, why don't you personally go do that right now if that's what you believe? Right? Like, if you believe that, why don't you personally go out and start killing Jews? If that's what you believe should be done, why don't you do that? And you get this sort of like, well, you know, I'll be put in jail, or, you know, I'll get killed in the process. It's so when, you know, this, I just want to get your comment on this to see if you can have some clarity on what I'm thinking here, but they don't seem to really want to do it themselves, but they want this sort of thing to kind of make it happen for them. What do you think about that?
Statists are absolutely always cowards, whether they're statists with power or statists trying to get power. They, and all the, you know, the perfect example is the freaking snowflake brigade that constitutes the white nationalists. They want a gang to march around with their tough gang to feel important and powerful. They don't want to go do it by themselves because somebody's going to kick their butt. But the whole gang mentality is driven, and this is true of street gangs or, you know, these political movements or even political parties, that whole mentality is driven by insecurity and fear. Like, by myself, I'm just this little thing and I feel powerless, but if I join a gang, we can be all tough. And I mean, the symbol of fascism is a bunch of little sticks tied together to make it really strong. That is the heart and soul of the concept of fascism. It's violent. Collectivism is, you know, instead of like being individuals who individually do things and have our beliefs and have our priorities, let's bunch together so we don't have to be so scared of the world. So it's always based on fear and insecurity, and then they want to look big and tough, and they're usually just the biggest wimps on the planet if you get them alone. And we'll just say what you think, say what you believe, do what you say you believe in. Don't run off trying to get a gang together so you feel strong. You're just a pansy. And so it really is, statism is always unprincipled cowardice, regardless of the flavor of you know, where on the political spectrum it is, and regardless of whether they have any power or not, because the white nationalists are trivial, but they're still like, we want to get together and have this power, because we... And they're still, you know, percentage-wise, they're dinky little nothing, but they want that to feel powerful. Like, how often do you see, you know, one white nationalist walking down some inner city street saying, white power, let me out of here. They want to feel powerful. They don't dare to just say what they think as themselves. They want the group behind them. They want the collective to make them feel like they're less responsible for what they condone and what they do. Their mob mentality. Statism is always mob mentality.